Do you like investing? I hope so. That's why you're watching this video. It's usually how that works. Because in this video, we're going to dive into how to use and build an investor portal inside of Softr. Now, why would you need an investor portal? An investor portal is a great place to track all of your investments inside of a simple system. And if you're a company that's getting invested in, it's really great to see the funding rounds and your communications with your LPs. It is mainly used for investment firms or venture capitalists. And by using something like this, this information is organized and centralized, taking advantage of opportunities and keeping track of the progress of the investments. Now, obviously we have a template for this, and this is going to be the star of this video. If you want to get it, make sure to check out the link down below. The investor portal template can be checked out by going to this preview window and then signing in with one of the magic links, or you can use the template. And we're going to walk through exactly how this works in this video. So when clicking on this, we'll see that there's a template for the investor portal. We'll go press use template, continue, and copy the base to my Airtable account. And once the base is added, we'll be good to go. Now with this template, you have a few user groups. So if we go to the user section, you'll see that there are a few default users here. And in the base, there's an administrator and an associate role. And the differences in these are going to be showcased throughout this video. And in the preview, you can quickly see if we go to Lucy, and this is the case with a lot of different administrative roles, I would recommend that you essentially notice here on the top, we have this basic header that showcases the companies, funding rounds, people, limited partner. Then we have an add company and add LP option. So just taking a look at the associate role, very similarly, we're gonna see a lot of the same stuff, but you'll notice that there isn't an option to add anybody at the top here. Now the reason for that is in the template itself, we go to the home and we click on this, we'll see that from a visibility standpoint, the user group that can see this is administrator, whereas the user group that can see the other one is the associate. And what those buttons can do is go to the page add company and go to the page add limited partner or LP. If you want to try this out in our own app, I would recommend that you press publish and then go into your user groups and take a second to create some magic links for the people in the different roles. You'll see here, we already have some people with specific roles like Lucy and Dominica. And then using Softr's wonderful sync, once this finishes, it'll have a two-way sync going with the base inside of Softr. So for example, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find Lucy and Dominica here. I'm just gonna refresh the magic links here, then copy this. And you'll see as I'm logged in now, the option to go to these different pages. I really like this dashboard because on the homepage, it showcases the new companies that exist, and then it showcases them by the different months that they are here. And the way that this is set up is that this is taking the dashboard view here. And this is essentially just a manual data input for the different dates and then the number of companies. And then the funding rounds is taking it from the Airtable funding round stats. So we'll see in here, the funding rounds, we have the ID property here, and then we have the entirety of this, essentially showcasing what kind of stage was this in, what's the status of it, whether it's literally been sent or not, and then the amount of money given, as well as the valuation that it was given at. And then it is connected to the company itself. So when we go into the application, we'll then see that we have these different companies. And as you can see, since I'm an admin, I can add a company. And in the back end, you'll see that it allows me to add the name, description, logo, website, industry, and all of the basic information, as well as founded year and the exit. So this gives us a vibe of what necessarily we are putting in money-wise. And then this is filtered to the latest funding rounds. And then we also have the LP updates here at the bottom. So I like this dashboard. I think it's a great start and homepage. And if we were to, for example, want to add a company as well as an admin, we would go here and there'd be an entire page dedicated with a form to this as well. Shout out to the field for Twitter feed. Very important field. And then if we wanted to add an LP as well, administrators would be able to do this and add a form submit here as well. If you wanted to tweak this form submit at all, we'll see that the limited partners have this setup here. So you'll notice that this is got their name, email, description, and phone number. But in the back end, let's take a look at the form. If we wanted to add a hidden field here, what we could do is we, for example, could add a field that's, let's say we would add a field called single line text, And then we could do created by, and then actually link it to the users. And then in here, we could showcase which admin ended up adding this to their team, right? So we could go here and then put hidden, and then we would map it to created by, and then select the value, and that would be the logged in user's name. So then for example, if I were to go here, and if I was adding an LP, limited partner to example at email.com, cool description, and then we put a number in there that's obviously real, and submit the partner. Then we went inside of here, we'd see that Lucy ended up creating this and it mapped it with a hidden field, which is always so convenient. We love hidden fields here at Softr. Now, a couple other looks at the different pages, because we've already gone through the homepage. The companies page is just got a great view of the different companies that exist within here. And you can also add companies if you are an administrator. Going into one of these companies, for example, I could click on learn more, or I could have filtered through any of the different ones there. And then we just get the information that it includes them. And if we wanted to add a funding round, we could. It goes to this form here that we then would submit. If we wanted to showcase portfolio news, it would go to this information. And then this is just essentially sending us to the different spots. So like add article, this is the news. And then there's also the option to add employees to this company. So we'd see the employee directory. Now, what's really cool is once that's added, we would see these funding rounds pop up, which showcase the companies, and then we could filter to a specific company or search a name like Brandingo. Then once we click on the funding round, would showcase the amount of the funding. And then if we wanted to get more about the info of the company, we can click in here. So this is very well interconnected. And then very similarly, we also have the option to look at the different people at the companies on this page. So if I wanted to take a look at one of them, I could click on this email in order to send an email. I have a link like that to open our mail app with. We could also filter by the organization, like QuickMove, for example. We'd be able to see all the people that work there, or search by name, email, or org. And then last but not least, the limited partner page has a great view of all the different limited partners that are here, and it shows what company they are from on the side. So very well interconnected. I believe that going into the companies page, this is one of the better, well-filtered detail pages that I've seen. You're able to even click on see funding rounds right here and visit their website, and in one click, we'll get to their website or the website of the app that we're using, which is Softr. But between the dashboard and being able to track everything inside of Softr, between the people that are in there, the limited partners and everything else, I believe that this is one of the best investor portals that you can find. And if you want to invest your money in Softr, make sure to subscribe to our product, as well as check out all of our other content that you can see about Softr right here.